Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Sunday morning service. You may stand. I'm your moderator for today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise, O Father. Hallelujah. Let's bow and pray. Father, we give you thanks for today, Lord Father. Father, as we pray to the Heavenly Father, thank you for everyone that is here, Lord Father. Thank you for our service, Lord Father. Bless everyone. Guidance, protection, Lord Father. Father, Lord, let your Holy Spirit come into our lives, Lord Father. Come fill our hearts, Lord Father. Fill this place with your presence, Lord Father. Father, Lord, bless the speaker, Lord Father. Bless the musician, Lord Father. Bless the technician, Lord Father. Bless the camera person, the computer person, Lord Father. Bless the worshippers, Lord Father. Father, Lord, bless everyone that is here, Lord Father. Bless your family, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. As we welcome the worship, let's give them a hand, please.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you.
You are God. Thank you. see Trinidad too. Anybody else?
Praise the Lord. That's good. Not everyone's hungry for. We'll be in the same in my life again.
Amen.
Well, it's good to be on. Thank you. The pain some people bear. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. A pleasant good morning. A pleasant good morning. A pleasant good morning. Amen, amen, amen. I want us to do a little exercise, please. God is good. Could we all just stand and just worship God for a minute, please?
Hallelujah!
Come on, let's praise Him. Hallelujah! Father, we glorify Your name. We glorify Your name this morning. Jesus! Somebody shout, Jesus! 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 Hallelujah! There is power in the name of Jesus. There is healing in the name of Jesus. There is victory in the name of Jesus. We bless Your matchless name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, thank You, Father. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Bless You. You may have your seats, beloved. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, I stayed up and I watched West Indies Real beat up Uganda last night. And I was making noise. I know my wife was in Japan, I was making noise. So why can't I make noise for Jesus this morning? When we come to the house of the Lord, I have to tell the technicians to turn down the volume here. But we can raise our volume. Amen?
Amen.
We don't need no amplifier. We don't need no microphones. Let us give Him the seed. Because the scripture says if we don't praise Him, He will cause the rocks to rise up and rain. I don't want no stone praise God for me. I'm going to praise God for myself. As long as I have breath, let everything that I have breath
praise God.
And you say, those are the string instruments. I didn't even know string instruments have breath. But you see when you amplify it, it gets breath. Let everything that had breath. Man, there's no dumb dog. I'm not preaching. We have a preacher this morning. It ain't even dumb dogs in Israel. Dog talking in Israel. Hallelujah. We want to stay quiet. No. God has been tremendously good to us, beloved. We are here. We are alive. I'll never tell you something. Come up here. You're looking really, really nice. Really, really nice. So again, welcome to each and everyone. I'm seeing my audience here this morning. Ashana, it's good to have you here this morning there. Praise the Lord. Grandma, it's nice to see you again. Bless the Lord. And grandson, praise the Lord. Amen. Brother Hans and family. Amen. Friggin, just a Carol. You're calling me times. A few days now. But I did not, all right. Mama, it's good to see you too. Everybody, did you hear? Nice to see each and every one of you, all the families. Amen? Yeah. Hallelujah. This morning, I just want to share our announcements. And first to begin, for those of you who may not know, we have an intern from the West Indies School of Theology, our precious sister here, and she has homework to do. And for those of us who might not be acquainted, because this is the first time, this is the very first time that Agape Wanapo is having an intern from a Bible school. Now, an intern, they are sent to a church or they ask permission to come to a church and to do their first, is it the first year of internship at the church. And so they have work to do to report back to their professor or teacher or facilitator, whatever you may call them. And from time to time, she will share with us. She will be working together with Sister Mel in the Sunday school and the youth department. She will be present in the ladies. She has work to do. And we are very happy to have her. And this morning, she wants us, she has an assignment, and she apologizes that it's short notice, but we will facilitate her. Amen?
Amen.
We are our brothers and our sisters' keeper. She has about 30 of these papers here that she wants us to help her with. And the question, there are two questions. What do you like about our church? And I like how she put that, our church. What do you like about our church? And what can our church do to improve its ministry operations? Ministry or operations? Two questions. What do you its ministry or its operations. Amen? So, sometime, we're not doing the service, but just after service, think about it. Think about it. I want, Brother Ren, can you pass this out to me quickly, please, while I'm giving the announcement? Think about it. You can give like 5 pounds, please. Think about it, and immediately after, I think we have some pencils and pens at the back. Just take 2 minutes to think about it, but don't let your mind drift during the message. Think about the two simple questions, and please just write it down briefly for her, and she will collect it after this so that she can take that self-project this morning. Amen?
Amen.
All right, so while they're sharing out, you can still listen to me. This Thursday the 13th, at 7 p.m., we have men's meeting. Do we have any men in the house this morning?
Yeah.
Right. Good. This is for you. This is for us. Men's meeting. I think we have a deal with AC. Yeah, we can have something. Thursday evening, 7 p.m. men. Men's meeting and let me let you know something. For those of you that won't come, we usually have something nice. Beside the meeting, we have another meeting too. So please, guys, come on. Amen? The last meeting we had, how much, Mr. President, how much we had? About 20-something, man? Alright, so that was really good. So let us do better this time, alright? No, Sister Kim, no, amen. Amen. I see Sister Kim laughing, smiling from ear to ear. She know nice thing, you know. Friday the 14th of June, worship practice 6:30 p.m. sharp. Friday the 14th of June, worship practice 6 p.m. sharp. And this is not only for the worshipers, this is also for the musicians and the technicians. Amen. This morning we were having some problems again. And we need to straighten these things out. Amen? Agape Men's Ministry Curia, Sons of Issachar, they are called. Grand Barbecue on Saturday the 29th of June 2024 from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Anyone interested, please see Pastor or Brother Shanad for tickets. Chicken is $45. Do you have any more fish? Pork?
No pork.
No pork, but you won't be in trouble with one of them. All right, okay. You have two fish?
Not me,
they have fish on there. How much are the fish? 50 for the fish. All right? So we don't have the ticket, but we will always get it. No problem. And it will be delivered here. It will be delivered here. Now we need to get these tickets out today, please. How many tickets are there? Should I? How many? How many you have?
About 15 or so.
All right, about 15, only 15? All right, but if we cross that, we will get more tickets, all right? So just let him know as soon as church over, we get your tickets, all right? Sunday the 16th of June, worship and Father's Day service, 9 a.m. sharp. Are there any fathers in the house? Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Any ladies here? Yeah. The ladies, our ladies, are planning our Father's Day service. Come here the moment, do worship, play music. Women preach. Women minister to the men on that day. Come and relax. And I'm sure they will have refreshments for us too. Amen?
Amen.
All ladies, can we meet for 10 minutes right after service, please? Alright. I'm just reading the announcement. Not me, the ladies. We have a ladies' committee. We have set up a ladies' committee. Sister Mel, Sister Kim, Sister Donna, and Sister Kathy. And they will meet with you for 10 minutes immediately after service. Amen? Can we give the Lord a round of applause? Lord is good. Boy, if I know when I hear him, I was going to sing, Lord, I'll bring him one now. There's a door, yeah, you're not sing. Right now, we are ready for the word of God. Could we stand, please? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As we bring on the servant of the Lord right now, Brother Hans, sorry.
Lord,
come on, let's worship the Lord. Praise the Lord.
it's a wonderful, it's, and it's really lovely to see each and every one of you here this morning. You know, as I came in, I said, you know, the rain falling, and I said, boy, going past the days, when you see rain falling, people come to church. It tells me that we are ready to fellowship. We are ready to be together with each other. It means something. It shows that, listen, that rain and wind and stops. But you remember the days when rain said, oh, Pastor, I got 3 people trickling. But we give God praise and thanks for everyone is here this morning. And they look wonderful, as Pastor said. All right? You know, we are in a lot of trouble in this world today. We're facing it right or wrong. You can see everything that is being transpired, everything that is happening. It's happening not only here, abroad, and you know, even last weekend, I had some of the challenges of my own. Thank God for the prayer of the brethren. You know, it was a really close friend of ours. Just got a little headache, and that was it. Went to the hospital, never came back up. Very, very sad, strong young man, and you know, it was really sad to see him go. So that just isn't it. Let us know and remind us. We need to know our position.
That's right.
What is our position as believers? It's all well and good to come through the rain and be here this morning. But are we just being numbers, part of the numbers here this morning? Or are we truly connected to God? Amen. And that's what we want to talk about this morning. Amen. I want to remind us, if you look at the world, even at land of Israel, what is happening right now. We are seeing, you know, the world is just coming up against Israel, and these things have been prophesied. So we have to know the signs of the times are there. You know, it's not, you know, we don't have much time, brethren. There's not much time to play around.
That's right.
Yeah, if you're looking for it, you're going to see it. And brethren, we are here. God has placed us in an arrangement that we can remind each other, that we can edify the body, that we will all be happens in common, looking for his appearing. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So I'd like to just at this time just let's go to Word of God. And this morning we want to look at John chapter 15. Very familiar passage. It tells us a lot. And today I think it's something that we need to really get ourselves, you know, attached to and remind us who we are and our position in Christ. It's not just about coming to church. It's not just about handing out a tract. It's not just about getting up and saying your prayers, as some people say. It's much more than that. Amen? Let's do some reading this morning. Praise the name of the Lord. Alright, so we have John chapter 15, I'm reading from verse 1. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh it away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can he, except he abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, he can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch, and is withered. And men gather them, and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit, so shall ye be my disciples. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments. brethren of God, we can come together, O God, and seek you in your words. Even this morning, as I minister, Father, I pray, O God, that you speak through me, O God, that your Holy Spirit continue to speak, O God, to this body, dear Lord, Father, O God, that we, O God, will be strengthened, O God, that we will be, O God, encouraged, O God, that we will take up our rightful place, and we will continue, O God, to work, O God, together with you. Mighty God, we thank you, and we praise you as we go forward here this morning. You take full control in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen.
Glory.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Brethren, scripture here is giving us a clear cut of who Jesus is, who God is, and who we are. Amen. So this is, we are seeing the positions that we are and where we are in that frame. That whole framework, we are going to see where we fit in and our operation and what is expected of us. Brethren, it's a time now that we need to stay connected to God. Amen? Because even when you see the time is approaching now, we are coming out more so, we should be together and fellowship. But not in just any manner, but we have to do it in a true and a faithful way. Amen? So it begins by saying in verse 1, I am the true vine. When you hear I am the true vine, we know it's talking about divine. Divine and divine. Amen? And I am speaks about God himself. He's the I am that I am. And we understand that even Jesus Christ has all authority. He can use that title because he himself is God. Yes. Amen? There is no difference between him and the Father. When you see him, you see the Father. And we give God praise and thank God that we were able to obtain that same God within ourselves. He made it that we could have accepted him, that we could come in that communion and that fellowship, and we now, we can say we are God men and God women, because he now dwells in us. Amen? He said, I am the true vine. Why that word true is there? It's very important to observe that word true. Because he didn't say, I am the vine. Mean that if he's the true vine, means that there is other vines. And then maybe fake vines, false. So we got to be careful of the vine that we're talking about. But he is clearly putting himself aside these other vines. And he's letting us know that he is the true vine. He is the genuine vine. He is the vine of the vines. The King of kings and the Lord of lords. Amen? So he said, I am the true vine and my Father is the husbandman. Father is the husbandman. He had a good husband. That husband also talks about master of the house. Alright? But the husbandman in this case here is talking about one that owns property and owns the land and cultivates the land and has the land, prepare the land to bring fruit. To bring food or fruit. In this case, it's fruit. To bring forth fruit. And you know, if you look at, we have farmers among us that be able to tell us how this, the operations and the work of a farmer. He is also an overseer of the land. He looks and takes care of the land, make sure that it's well prepared and but there's a purpose in why he has everything laid out there, why he put the land. His whole goal is to bring forth fruit. Amen? So that's the position of the Father. He is there and he placed the vine there. The true vine. This is the way that he made that way. Remember they said that in the scripture that tells us, just right there, it tells us that I am the way, that is in John 14. I am the way, the truth, and the life. He's the way, the truth. So it's tying in here with, you know, just continuing saying that I am the true vine. He is continuing to do, that's me here. I am the true vine. I am the way, the truth, and the life. If you're in me, you will live. If you're not in me, you will die. I'll be warning you to see how that's going to work. Alright? Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh it away. Taketh that away. Just removes it. Alright? So that is is something you have to pay attention. All right, and every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it. My God, we're talking here about he is the source, and he has us connected to him. So with that, so he being the source, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, he is our source, and we are connected to him. We are in the vine. We are the branches. That's what he said. We are the branches. We are the branches, brethren. We're going to see that Lord now in verse 5. But we are connected to the vine, which is our source, and we need to be and stay connected to the vine. Because we, if we are not connected to the vine, we would not be able to live. It's simple. We will not be able to breathe. We will not be able to live. We will not be able to move and operate and just operate in the way that God would have us to. He has a plan for us, brethren. And in order for us to be able to execute the plan and for us to be part of and parcel of it, we have to stay connected. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. And we, and the farmers, they continue. I look at the work that the first man does. It's such a, we have to give God praise and thanks and thankful for how God cares for us. You know, that he prunes it. The Bible tells us here that, you know, he take it away if we fail. If we not. So he so wants to make sure that we have room to grow and to exist and to be comfortable. That if there is anything that hindering it, continue to clean it, shave it, prune it, because he wants healthy fruit. He wants the branch to be able to flex and to be able to breathe and be able to get all the nutrients that it gets, that it needs to survive. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord. So he's a caring God. He's a caring and loving God. And the whole point now is that we hear about purging and we hear about cleaning, and but how is that done? In the natural, someone will take a cutlass and they will clean. They will come with a spray can, they will come with the clippers. But in the spiritual, how that is done, and this is where we are dealing with here this morning. We are dealing with our lives, we are dealing with what we ask the branches. How are we dealing with that? How God wants to deal with it. You know what he wants to deal with? He wants to clean us through his words. Amen? Let's hear what he says here. Now, in verse 3 said, now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Amen? The word of God that he has spoken unto us, he has given us the instruction from Genesis to Revelation. And every portion of scripture is connected. And there's a pathway as we continue to seek God in his word, that we would see that God have us on a course and that he continues to clean us through his word. His word is true.
Yes, sir.
His word is forever. His word is the one that is going to look at our lives, and when we can reflect and do introspection on our lives and see where we are failing, where we are falling. But when you seek God's word, it can tell us where we're at, what are we falling short with, and what we need to do to get back in that place that God will have us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. All right. Praise his name. Yes. So it's something that we need to stand and address, brethren. We need to seek God in his words. Now, if we're not seeking God, God will just want to keep words and just throw over here. Pastor will come up here and preach. Ministers will come up here and preach. I will share the word, and they never just be in with that. You sit down there folding on here. You study that, what they're gonna eat, but they put the crab. They didn't clean the crab, then we go home, they gotta want to clean that crab, you gotta want the flour. Your mind not even on the word, you're not even there, you're not allowing the word to saturate on your mind elsewhere. How could you be washed in the word? How can the word cleanse you? The Bible talks about washing of the word, and we can see that in Ephesians. Let's see what you get that. Praise the name of the Lord. That says in Ephesians 5:26. And see if we can get that up. Praise the name of the Lord. As we continue divine. Amen? That's it up there. Now we are clean through the word. Ephesians. Yes, so yes, as you know, he wants to clean us, and it's through his words. Alright? God removes anything that hinders us from being useful. Because he wants to use us. So anything that is uses, they see the weaknesses we have. But trust me, we have flesh. And each and every one of us have weaknesses. And you know what he wants to do? He wants to trim those weaknesses. Trim them off. And that's his job. He's looking at us. He loves us. He cares about us. And he wants to see us prosper in him and bring much fruit. So he continues to trim off the weaknesses. Amen? Alright. That ye may be sanctified and cleansed in with the washing of water by the word. Hallelujah. Imagine that. And that washing you're talking about there. You gotta think about it, brother. I don't think it is true everybody who is seeing washing machine and have it spin around and cycle. God is a personal God. As we have a personal relationship with him, he takes his time. You know what, yeah? He had one of them, you know, they scrub it already in the ribs and the bone. Remember the joking God? That is what he had. And he take it one piece by one. Some of us, we have a little chicka chicka. Turn it on your chicka. Read a little song, chicka. Right? And then some of us have a go down the middle right here, so. You understand? Some of us had to get that. And when they're coming out and they see this thing, reach for this scrub and brush. And on the grater, you hit in here, ragata, and they come up. So it's different. Alright? He deals with us personally. Every single one of us is at a particular level in Christ. But we are all on the path and strive that we walk. That we will walk and we will stand and we will fight the good fight of faith. And that he is going to be with us and he is going to stay with us. He is going to empower us that we will bear much fruit. Hallelujah. Amen. So God cares for us and he cleanses us.
Washes us by the word.
Bless the Lord. Alright, you know these things happen.
Yeah.
But you see, that is going to stop us this morning. Because what God wants for us this morning is for us to understand our position in Him, in Christ. Hallelujah. And we need to know that position because we need to stand now and observe our lives going forward. And ain't no joke. This is a serious time. He's on his way. And I thank God this message came to me because it's a message that we need to understand our position. Don't just do something for doing something's sake. We got to stop that. Just going to church for going to church's sake. And we're just making up the numbers. I said, a good time. And oh, God, but I hate to sing. Good boy. Oh, good. I love to hear him sing. And they come to hear a little worship. No. It's not just they come to hear a little worship. You come to worship God. Amen. I ain't come to hear pastor preach. I listen to the word and the word wash me as pastor preaching. You understand the difference? So the intention is different than it is coming. You all have a part to play. We all have a part to play. Because we are all connected in that vine. You have to understand that this true vine we're talking about, each and every one of us is connected to this vine. Just look at it. Remember our vine. You see, you're looking at the vineyard, the vine that bears the grape. It has the vine coming up this way, and then you will see a little one that is a little branch, and then you see it stems out, and then you will see fruit coming off from the branch. And you will see another way, a long vine, another one, another branch, and another fruit. So we all hooked up together, brethren. You can get a picture. We are all connected to brethren. That's why he tells us, he commanded us to love each other. Because listen, regardless of what, he has designed us to love each other because we together in one. You can't love yourself. We are all one. We connected as one. We have to go forward. We have to minister as one. We have to stand as one. And when we that. Yeah, he just knows that we really love him. And we are his disciples. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord. Alright, so we know that he cares for us. We know how he washes and cleanses us because he loves us and he cares for us. What about it? Let's go further in verse 4 when he said, abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except abide in the vine. No more can he accept he abide in me. So brethren, when you look at that, there is this talking, you see that food, a connection here in the scripture where it's showing relationship.
Yes.
This is a relationship, this is a partnership, and this is also fellowship. And this is what this is talking about when he's telling us here, abide in me. We are instructed here now to abide in him. Abide in who? Jesus. Brethren, Jesus is the true vine. And we are instructed to what? Abide. Stay connected. And it's not just you're there for a while and then you're gone. Is that stay and abide is just you can't move. Abide is there. That is where you drop it. You ain't putting up a wood shopping. You're going on that right now. You pop a little tent, a little shed there, and you know, well, alright. I just see a little spot in a little area here. No, it's not that. When you're building concrete with rock and the foundation, that's where you're standing. So you know you're not moving from there. You know when you build a little shop there, they say, break it up because you have intentions, you might say, but just in case, remember just put a little small thing there, you know, because just in case they decide after the. In this case, the instruction to you by the boss himself, by the governor general, is to say, nobody can move you. What do you think about it? Nobody can move you. You was given the instruction and the authorization to abide. Where we go, you tell me we can leave there. Never tell them to go your way. Sometimes we go on me. Go on your own way, doing your own thing. And but who gave it out to me? Where was the command to leave? Where was the command? We have seen that you only have a little bit, the timing is short. You listen. No. That's not the case. He said, abide in me and I in you. Hallelujah. So the thing about today, when you abide in me, when you draw close to me, that's what they, when you draw close to me, I will draw close to you. Hallelujah. This is, we see the expression of it here. We are seeing, he's saying, abide in me and I in you. He is in us. Hallelujah. He dwells in us. He dwells in us, and that's why we live now. Yes. We don't live the life that we used to live. We live a new life. Our life is in Christ because he is in us. Hallelujah. He dwells in us.
Glory.
Oh my goodness, that connection there. You can't help but be know that we're not Christ. Not the one who knows all, sees all, who holds us in his hands.
Yes,
the one who can speak and it can come to being. My goodness, that's the Lord who died and he laid down his life and picked it back up.
Yes.
So that spirit, that same spirit that raised Christ from the dead now dwells inside of us. Brethren, come on. We have to be thankful. We have to know the power of God that is in us. We have to know that God is in us. He is for us. He gives us the authority to stay there. Who will know us? Come on, brethren. Let us stay. Don't make a little thing come and any little problem or this family and that neighbor and what? Come on, brethren.
Hallelujah.
And the authority of God, he tells me to stay. And I them little petty little things coming around. I want to move. I want to shake. No, brethren. Abide. I want to live. I want to live forever, brethren. I'm sure you want to live. We want to live. And we want to live the life that God has us to live. So we need to abide in him. And he is going to be in us. So that power of God is in us, brethren. Let's do this. Sit down with all that power. Let's just sit down with that power. Know who you are in Christ. Who you are in Christ is Christ in you. Understand that. And he is the one that has all power. He's the overcomer. So no situation can come at you. So let's be able to encourage ourselves. If you didn't have that, you would be very miserable. You could be hopeless. But now Christ and that Christ is in us. And give us all authority to stay there. We in him and he in us, and we wrapped up together. Where are we going? Nowhere. Hallelujah. As the branch, right, cannot bear fruit of itself except it abides in the vine. Brethren, if we're not connected, we can nothing. You know what we become? Useless. We're just picking up space. We're just wasting time. And it tells me, if you're just there, and you're not bearing fruit, and you're wasting time, the husbandman passage, you know, he's a cleaner. He's a pruner. He's not going to allow that. Because the fact about it is, he wants the vine to be healthy. And these branches, they're just weighing down the vines and sucking the vine. They're just drawing from it the nutrients that flow into the rest of the branches that want to bring forth fruit. So you know what he does? Snippy snip. Takes it out. And you don't want to be on that end, brethren. We, none of us, want to be on that end. So we need to keep checking our position and what we're doing. Are we bearing fruit? Are we positioning ourselves right with God? Are we connected and are we ready? And are we flowers and are we looking to bring forth fruit? Are we giving some kind of sign that we are with God? Because if you look at that flower coming out, you know, it's a name of flower. Nothing, just a sign that they're ready, they're preparing yourself. You know, to bring fruit, we need to get ready because you cannot do it by yourself. You can't muster it. And the thing about it is, if you do it and you try to do it by yourself, what will you produce? Will it be authentic fruit? A genuine fruit? You know what it'll be? It will be an AI fruit. Artificial. And that fruit, artificial fruit, we'll talk about that. And we also talk about when your fruit is not ripe, when it's from the other. You don't want to be like that. That is not the yes, false ripe is the word that's okay. You don't want to be false ripe. You'll bring that fruit. Looking like you're ripe. But when you're really watching, it don't really have the size as the rest of them. Some of them smaller. So it looked like it was lacking some kind of thing. And in the end, when the fruit come out, it tasteless. There's no taste. Artificial, it's the thing. Right now, you know that they're making China, making everything. They're making fruit, they give you fruit, they pay a fruit now. They just put the fruit there, so you want fruit now, they give you a fruit now. They're making that, they give you a fruit. Artificial fruit, you come like that, food, everything. Artificial, and we live in that kind of world. And people want to become artificial as well. And we want to serve God in an artificial way. And try to see if we cut corners and read. That is not allowed. Amen? As a true believer, and is connected to the vine, yes. That is not allowed.
Amen.
It will look wrong. You think the husband man would know that? The husband man watching that and say, yeah, they're right. That they're right. Alright, so let's be genuine in what we do. Let me stand in what we do, brethren. And know that what we're doing is not artificial, but we position ourselves to bring forth genuine food. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord. And we can't do it without, you know what I mean, staying connected and staying. We can't do it with self. Alright? And that is when it goes before we are. Right? Let's go to verse 5. I am the vine, he are the branches, he that abideth in me, and I in him. The same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me he can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered, and men gather him up. So when you think about that, the scripture that comes in Psalms 1:1, that scripture always comes into play and into mind. Psalms 1:1. You know, because it's telling us here, you know, that if a man abide not, if we're not really in there, he's cast forth. Alright? And it says in verse 1, we just read from verse 1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Are you going to do this? Are you better? Alright. Sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But next one. But his delight
is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate, in the word doeth he meditate day and night, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. This is it. This is the Bible region here. And he is like a tree, brethren, planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. When you look at that, in contrast to what they're saying here, right? If a man abide not in me, he is scarce for it. We thank God, and we can look at this and we can say, once we abide in the vine, we are planted, as the scripture says, by rivers of water. You can imagine. That river you're running dry, that flowing evermore. And you connected there, and you are just pulling in all the nutrients, everything that you need to bring forth much fruit. Brethren, this is where God wants to, position ourselves. To position ourselves, and he will just know, and he will just be able to just, you know, just give us all we need to continue to grow healthy and strong. But let's go back to the scripture, verse 16. If a man abide not in me, let's read and really understand. He is cast forth as a branch. We talked about that already. And is withered. That withering there, brethren. We be losing something. We drying up. We drying up, brethren. Because we're not connected. So we drying up. But here this part. And men. Men, listen. Now, as a believer, now we've seen it here as we bring it the illustration through a platform. But if we go in the natural form, as a man form, you'll see as a believer your walk starts to befall you. You start to walk away from God. Your connection with God is no longer there. And once that gap, now we always know that there is no good or bad side there. And there's no gray, there's no gray area in between. It's either you're in or you're out. It has no real estate between that. Right? But somehow we like to think so. And when we are in this position, brethren, and we start to walk and create that space between God, we're already out. But we are fooled. And our own intellect fools us. And we are in a position that we think we can still operate with God and we can do things. And yes, our fruit will come. It will come sometime whenever we're taking care. But we dare, we just distancing ourselves from God as we continue to disconnect from him. Space comes between us, and here this part of the scripture says, men preaching some kind of messages these days, brethren. They're all over the internet, social media. They're all on the big screen. Praise the Lord. And they continue to, as you draw away from God, you start to draw to these men. The false doctrine and false teaching of the word. Yeah, you're just moving away. So they're gathering you. They're gathering you. See it now, brethren? That the men, they're gathering you. What are they doing? They're bundling you up together. And they say, okay, you're not sure from God. So I have no hand. I make a way of, you know, coming. And they're giving you some deception. I know in the form of messages that is coming into play here now. And that's so important. It's not a question of your faith, because you know what? You disconnect yourself. So you can't draw from the source now to even get some help to put you back on the right foot. You can't get no help. You can't get nothing. You're cut off. And you're disconnected. And you're fading. So the men started to gather. You come with me here. This is the real way you have to come. I wanted to come. This is the way we're going down here, man. Yes, there's someone going to tickle in their head, and all they say is Jesus. But they're coming, what Jesus is talking about? And Jesus is the thing, they come with me. And they're going with you, they're saying Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And they're putting you in another vine, but it's not the true vine. Many will come in his name, brethren. Many will come and say Jesus, and it's not Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Just to pull you into their vine with this artificial which is not right. AI, they're coming in and just bringing you into that. So this is a part we need to take note of. Where are we? Where are we? How are we connected? A little tin piece or something? We sure that connection is still there? Are we just close? But yet not connected. You can be close here. If I snip it and never move it, you will drive it right here. If it cut off, right there. But as it started driving, your life and moving, it will start to take you. Like a chaff, as they click it says, and it will blow you away. Brethren, I know you're going. You're just going on the wrong side, but straight into hellfire. Fire. This is serious as a brethren. This is very, very serious. We have to take stock of our life now. This time, we have to take stock of our life. We have to. Because our very existence and our destination depends on if we are connected and staying connected and abiding in the true vine. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord. So be careful. Don't allow, you know, yourself to be disconnected. If you find you was a little far, you're better somehow. Call the gardener and call the cultivator. Man, call up Tontin. Because he know how to come and touch it back here and graft it in. And he know to do that.
Amen?
Amen? Thank God. He designed that. He know to put it back there. So if you feel you have been cut off, if you feel you have been distanced, call him. Say, husband, man, God Almighty, I need you. Put me back where I belong, Lord Jesus. Put me back where I belong, God. I want to be in you and you in me. Hallelujah. I want to be part of the true vine. I want to exist. I not know that I exist, but I want to exist in you that I will live forevermore. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So we don't want to end up in the fire, brethren. Don't be driven away. Don't do that. Just keep on standing ground. Continue to stand. And that standing is abiding in the Lord Jesus Christ. If, and it goes on to say in 7, if ye abide in me, hallelujah, and my word, so brethren, this is about the word of God. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will,
hallelujah,
and it shall be done unto you. Hallelujah. Oh boy, how we love this part. But if I can't get to this part, we're all standing in the part before to stay connected. Alright? Because he's telling now, if you abide. You notice he's saying if? Nobody's saying that two little letters over here. That if tells us it's conditional.
Yes.
We have a choice to make it. If we abide. Because quite frankly, there are some people don't want to abide.
Yeah.
Some people have chosen another path. Some people like vine but over too. And they're going down with that vine. But we know what our next one. Brethren, the words of God is in play here. We understand the words will wash us. We understand the word cleanse us. But we have to understand the word will keep us. The word of God, as the psalmist said, the word of God that I hear in my heart, that I will not sin against you. What separates us from God? Sin. Sin is what separates man from God. And the word of God tells us that by his words is what we have to stay in him. That is what will keep us from sin. That is what I keep. Not saying our Father prays 7 times. Right? Not make any trip to the mountain and come to the beach, brother. Not going on the bar. Not going to do babe. Knocking about and talking about. Not doing all the similes. Not doing all the rituals and all the formalities. Brethren, what we have to do is get into the Word of God and make sure that the Word of God take root in our lives, in our heart. You see that? In our heart, in that place, the place where God tries, where he sees, where he looks at us, not from the outward, but from the inward. And when we see we operate there, our inside is all for God. When your inside is full of a word, it's only word that come out from your mouth. When the enemy comes in, and you see God said he will raise a standard, is a standard in the word of God. That's his standard. His standard is in his words. His word is him. Hallelujah. So when you see the word of God, don't take it lightly. Don't think you come in here Sunday after Sunday and you think, you know, you just go in and like just go through the motion. Brethren, when the word of God is being ministered to you, you accept the word. And you don't say, well, right, good one, brother. I'm speaking this morning, but Brother Sharad did a good job last week. Thank God, brother. Go home and hallelujah. Brethren, this is how we get it in your heart. Because you need to search the scriptures.
Now listen,
he didn't say, I want Pastor Ramzan, seek God for the people. We all need to seek God ourselves. We have to seek God for ourselves. And we can only seek him through his words. His words is life. His words is power. His words is what keep us connected in divine. And it will prune us, it will wash us, it will cleanse us, and it will keep us from sinning, brethren. Hallelujah. And that's what we want. We want to stay sinless, blameless until his coming. And we know his coming is soon, because the sign of the times tells us so. And the same word that we have in his spirit, so it talks to us. It comforts us in our darkest moment. It comforts us. It lets us know, in all of us here, I have made a way. I return, I will take you unto myself. So he said, don't worry, don't be afraid. So when you read a word like that and you see what we're doing, we can comfort ourselves. So it brings comfort. It brings joy to our heart when we hear the word. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Hallelujah. So when we fellowship and when we hear the word and when we read the word, that God is there and everything, and those that love him and those that he loves us too, and that he will take care of us, and we can cast all cares upon him, and we don't think about those things. It brings a joy,
yes,
to our heart. So we are joyful people because of the word of God. And then you're open and you're sad and you're crying for every thing that come about. You're not in your trust. You're not grounded. You might read it, but you're not rooted and grounded in the word of God. And we as believers, now who are claiming to believe us, you just call yourself Christian, Pentecostal outside. We're not just that. I didn't say we are Christians, we're Christians. But we are believing Christians.
Yes.
Believers in Christ Jesus. In the word, Jesus Christ is the word that became flesh. Hallelujah. And he's the word that became flesh and walked and dwelt among us. He is the word, the same vine, the true vine. He is the word. So we are in the word, and the word is in us. We have to allow the word of God to now come forth and bear fruit. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. It says in verse 8 here, and winding up here, herein is my Father glorified, that he bear much fruit. This is purpose now, brethren. Purpose here. Purposely. Herein is my Father. Here Jesus saying, my Father now is honored. He's honored that you're bearing much fruit because you're planted and you're rooted by the rivers of water. And he sees that. You know why? Because you meditate. If anyone has a scripture, I want to, but that's the thing about meditate day and night. And what? On the word, and you shall be like a tree. So you have to meditate on the word day and night, brethren. That day and night, telling me as much time as you can get. Just taking up plenty of time. Me and all, we are guilty, Father. I'll be honest. Taking up a lot of time. And you have to be able to catch yourself for this time. Trust me, brethren, you have to catch yourself. Trust me. And then you sometimes say, how do I reach there, buddy? You reach there, you reach there.
Yeah.
This little thing, eh? Oh my goodness! I think my mommy won't repent. If I see something in the future, I have to watch myself. Come in whether I like it or not. Be careful, brethren. Let's be careful. All right. So, Father, He wants you need to. We want to bring honor, a sweet smelling savor, up to His nostrils. We want Him So we want to make God smile.
Your husband man has done this job.
You and Anne, what you can do it well. He's a faithful God. He's an honest God. He's a truthful God. But let's be faithful.
With all that pruning, with all that washing, with all that nurturing, and we are bringing nothing.
We need to honor God with fruit. We need to bear fruit. You know what I'm talking about? People might ask, we're going to be fine with it, and I'll not close up with that. So we want to honor our family by being disciples. By the same word that comes into us, brethren, this is what it is. It's the same word that we will live and will now express the same words, and we'll share those words as disciples as we go forward. Because that word has delivered us. That word has set us on course to victory in Christ. That same word that God has given us with and given us. It's the same word He didn't give us to keep it at home, go home and feel good. We are now disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ. So we have now to go and we have the ministry of reconciliation.
Amen.
So we have to go out there and make sure that men and women hear the word and they repent in their heart. The Spirit of God will do His job, but we need to do ours. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Just winding up here, as the Father had loved me, that will have to come in. This whole thing is about love, brethren.
That's right.
The husbandman did his job. And everything that he laid down, this whole foundation of the world, was laid because of love. Love is the true foundation. And the love that we're talking about here, he tells us that we supposed to command us to love each other. Let us just look at, as I close, let us look at the fruit of the Spirit. Let us look at Galatians. Praise the Lord. Galatians 5, 22 and 23. And even in this 10, while we're looking for that, we talk about, if they keep my commandments, shall abide in my love, as I have kept my Father's commandments.
Yes.
This here is talking about obedience. So I can say, oh, we say, the word of God, speak to your heart this morning. And speak to us as they continue, as the ministers continue to minister, as we put on whatever ministerial tools that we use and we continue to minister to, as we seek God, as we study the word. Brethren, you can just study it, you can just, and we don't apply it, we are not being obedient. We need to go a little further. It's always tell people about, and I'll do that for another time. We need to go and understand. Whatever we do, we need to obey God. In everything, there's man's side and there's God's side. We will always come with that. And who will we believe and who will we stand with? And we obey rather obey man than God. We know what man's intent is. We live in a cruel world, a wicked world. But a lot of men are just leading people astray and doing all this. The thing about it is, man can only take it so far. But with God, all things are possible. Amen? All things are possible. So let's look at Galatians. And it says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love. What is that love? Is the first fruit? Oh, that tells us a lot. The foundation. To lay everything on. Love. And joy. Hallelujah. Oh, the joy of the Lord. Joy unspeakable. Full of glory. The peace of God has surpassed all understanding. Everybody wants to take this one in. No. We need to suffer long and build patience and encourage and those that can endure till the end. We need long suffering. We need to be able to go through the trials and the temptations and all of this that will strengthen us up. And we can journey as we connect to divine, see your problem, know what is on, and supplies you. You have a boost here. If it's not connected, it's a problem virgin. You will suffer, not long alone, but you will suffer. You understand? You will suffer. So thank God for long suffering. That means we can suffer long. We can take. And He won't give you too much that we can't bear. Praise the Lord. Let me talk about gentleness. Oh, how Christian people are so nice. Maybe they were so nice. Brethren, love is
true love is in God, because God is love. And that, with all that love in our life, we can't be gentle. So you know, we can watch one another, and you can watch people that come in touch with them, and you ain't seen that gentleness and that love, and don't trust them. Something wrong. I ain't saying sometimes you be still, that time to be still. But brethren, fruit of the Spirit is also gentleness. We need to be gentle. We need to be, you know, mindful. And if we don't want to speak to people, we have to be conscious of how we speak, how we talk, how we approach things. Sometimes we rough up people for nothing. You know what I mean? Nice people, you just roughing them up. Oh gosh, I still have something to do. Rough folks. You know? We need to be gentle, brethren, and show that we care and we are concerned for each other. Just the way how we treat each other. Just we, and no, not just we, but the other, but he talks about specifically the those that are of the household. The way that we treat each other. Oh, but if we treat each other bad here, everybody outside is bullying. Because we are supposed to be able to treat each other with special love. That is getting us ready to treat people on the outside the right way. Alright? So we're talking about now goodness. Goodness, a closing brethren, goodness is beautiful. We love goodness. Yeah. And I remember young Azim, oh gosh, Steve's son. Steve was telling man that he said, Daddy, Steve was doing something Bible study and ritual devotion. And when he was reading scripture, he said, goodness and mercy shall fall all the day. Steve's young son said, Daddy, why you not stop and take the goodness? Why you have to have the goodness and then following you all the time? Goodness is running after me. See why? See the song? Goodness is running after me. And why the goodness? Why run after me? Why you stop and receive the goodness? Really, brethren, why you not stop and really receive the goodness of God? Because He is good. He is a loving God, He's a good God, He's a gracious God, He means good to us. And you see, if we don't have that spirit, we'd be miserable. We wouldn't know how to minister that goodness unto others. We wouldn't know how to do it. That's why He said, I'll give you that fruit. And now faith, brethren, faith is the substance of things not seen, the evidence of things not seen. We don't need to see it, brethren. We surpass in things. We don't want to see things to know things. That's what faith is about. We know that our God exists. We know that He lives and moves and He breathes. We know that He's a deliverer. He's a redeemer. We know that He's a rewarder of those that diligently seek Him. We know that He is the Word and the Word is Him. Hallelujah. And we are attached to the Word. Don't waste that prayer. So in closing, brethren, I just want to admonish us this morning. Let's look at purpose. Let's look at being obedient. Let's look at being connected. Staying connected to the truth. My blessings, brethren. Love you all.
Anything, but we're not connected.
Krishna is alive.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. Preacher, I love that message from God. Stay connected. You know, some of us, we're so mingy, or we don't want, we will find money to do everything else, but don't pay electricity bill. You know when they cut it?
Yeah, yeah.
We go borrow money to pay reconnection costs.
That's right.
Don't wait for your connection to cut.
Amen.
Pay your bill.
Amen.
Do what you have to do to be unto divine.
That's right.
Bear your fruit.
Hallelujah.
Bear your fruit. Because disconnection and reconnection costs. And immediately as they cut the current, they get money, you know, to pay. And we have to pay the extra 300 or 500, I don't know how much it is though. We have some electricians here. But the cost, know that. When you see you get disconnected from the true vine, it costs, you know. And if you could, like Peter, when he was going up in the water, Lord, save me. If you could call out to him. Sad to say, some people are cut off. And that without remedy, they did not get a chance to reconnect. Then they are lost forever. Today, beloved, we have a chance to reconnect to the true vine, to the source. Get your meter. Check your meter. Let me tell you something. We have to get up to date. You hear? Don't wait on TT Post to send your bill. No. Get on your phone. Get on your device. Maybe when you're on Facebook and you're on WhatsApp and TikTok and all kinds of things. Find out when your bill due and pay your bill.
Sure.
This assembly and this building here, even our home, my wife put things in place and it's coming on the email. We have email. Get an email for Jesus. Get a email so that you will stay in connection and know when your bill due. How great to disconnect, brethren. Don't wait till you get sick. Don't wait till you start to feel dry and you're drying up. Fire behind that. We read in the scripture. Stay connected. The moment you start to feel dry, hey, thank you for the rain, Father. Get under the showers of blessing. Come in. This morning when we started, and we were too quiet. Get the rain. The rain glorifying God. The room glorifying God. And we got in the circle in the assembly line. Oh my God. We love it. Get connected. Can you stand and ask him to set a good heart?
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, the word of God is blessed. Hallelujah. Father, we give you thanks. Brethren, let's just get into that atmosphere of, you know, really knowing who we are, that we are connected to the true vine. And brethren, if we are connected to the true vine, trust me, we're not dead fast. We are supposed to be alive and well. We are supposed to have voices that will, you know, go together up to heaven. Hallelujah. We're supposed to come together and we are supposed to be a joyful people. And we are supposed to be a praying people. We have time as we come together and unite in the brethren. We can open our mouths and let's reach out to God. Let us let him know that we are grateful that for who he is. That he is a God that oversees over us. And that he cares for us. And that he continues to prune us and cleanse us and wash us. Mighty God, we thank you, O God. We thank you, God, for this day that you have made. We thank you, God, that we can go into your words. Your words, oh God, is life, Lord Jesus. And even as we go into your words this morning, we thank you, God, that your words have taught us this morning that we have to stay connected. Mighty God, I pray, oh God, that each and every one of us here this morning, that we will continue to abide in the vine, and that abide is to stay in you. That we, oh God, will be unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Mighty God, that we will shine, our light will shine, oh God, that men will see that the world can glorify, oh God, the Father which is in heaven. Mighty God, I ask, oh God, to touch each and every one of us in our weak areas. Trim them, oh God. Prune us, oh God, by the washing, oh God, by your word. Let your word, oh God, just take free course to, oh God, just wash us from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. That, oh God, we be cleansed from all unrighteousness. and sister over our wrong and where we have erred. We ask for your mercies this morning. That, oh God, we will stay and that, oh God, we will be fruitful in the name of Jesus, because we will be healthy vine, we'll be healthy in the vine. We will be branches, oh God, that will continue to reach out and reach out at the lost, oh God, and dying world out there. That we'll be branches that will bear fruit, oh God, that people will, oh God, know that you are God when they see us. They can see Christ in us, oh God. That's the purpose of us to bear fruit, so that when they see the goodness in us, when they see you in us, they too, oh God, will want to be part of the vine. Mighty God, touch us as we continue to be, oh God, ambassadors for Christ. Let us stand together, stand united in one, in the true vine. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Yes, give him praise. Give him praise. Thank you, Jesus. Just before we go, beloved, our dear sister, when they arrived at the door, waiting on the forms and the paper that you were just writing. But remember also that our ladies have to meet for just a few minutes so that we will do your final supplement for our next week program. Shall we bow in prayer? Father, we give you thanks today for your goodness, your mercies, your grace, your word, most of all for your presence in us today. We thank you for the worship, we thank you for the testimonies, we thank you for the special song, we thank you, O God, for every minister here this morning. We thank you, Father, for the word of God to our hearts. We thank you for your people in a special way. We pray that your word will germinate, O God, and bring forth much fruit as we connect and as we stay connected to you, the true and living vine. Bless each family here. Cover each family in the name of Jesus. Father, protect each family. Every home right now, we cover under the blood of Jesus. Every child that goes through, we cover in the name of Jesus. Every driver, Lord, protect against accidents, against ignorance, against bad drivers on the streets. Cover today.